Hey everyone, Moonswing here, and welcome to my video of different skew setups for Test of Strength skips. By utilizing a trick called Shield Clipping, we can skip every single Test of Strength in the game. Now if you don't know what Shield Clipping is, I strongly suggest watching Swiffy22's tutorial vid on YouTube. It teaches how to Shield Clip and its mechanics. I will include it in the description below. You should also just follow Swiffy on their Twitter and YouTube since they have been monumental in the development of speedrunning in Breath of the Wild. So, by utilizing this trick called Shield Clipping, we can do this. But in order to do this for each of the shrines, we need to set the skew to a specific direction. So this video is specifically to help find good quality skews for each of the Test of Strength shrines, as well as provide some basic analysis on why they are effective or not. Now for those looking for the skew setups immediately, I've time-logged all of them in the description below, so feel free to just jump down there and click on the one that you need. But for everyone else, before getting into the specific shrines and their skews, there's a crucial part of this that we need to understand before continuing. Now we learned in Swift's tutorial that in order to clip through a wall we're facing, that we need a skew that goes quote-unquote backwards. Now what's really important to know is that your skew level is defined by the direction of the slope you are shielding on, but furthermore, this is set by its cardinal direction. Now this is important because all of the Test of Strength shrines default Link to facing True North. We know this because when we enter the shrine and open the map, we can see that he is facing True North. So what this means is that if we're getting our skew out on the overworld, that we need to get it on a slope that is either downward facing south or upward facing north. Understanding this will help us find good setups for skew on the overworld. But before I play through all of the shrines, I do want to make a really important disclaimer. Now this tutorial as well as all of the skew setups in this video are not the end-all be-all strategies to this. Breath of the Wild is a beautiful game that allows you to express your creativity and journey in so many wonderful ways, and the same applies to speedrunning. So while I hope this video does help you, I also hope it inspires you to find your own setups and find more optimized strats so that you can then make your own unique journey in this speed game and then share it with the community. Now speaking of community, there is an incredible Discord that you can join to ask questions, share your creativity, and hang out with other Breath of the Wild speedrunners. I'll post the link to that in the body as well. Alright, now enough is enough. Let's go through every single Test of Strength shrine in my skew setups. When you see the red dot in the corner, that means the upcoming attempt is unsuccessful, and I will say why. Now I do think it's important to see unsuccessful attempts when you're trying to learn a new trick. The green dot means the upcoming attempt is successful. Enjoy. So first off, we're going to start with Tylo Nag. I strongly suggest doing this one first. It's fairly fail-safe. You're going to aim to shield bonk on this little circle up here. And we're going to face west and just test it out. Looks good. This is a good shrine to practice on because the guardian is stationary normally. Okay, this one is you're gonna basically face the left part of the door here. You wanna bonk right where that circle is. Looks good. So I fail this one because I aim a little bit too far to the left, but you'll see here. So we gotta zigzag up this little thing. We're gonna shield jump up here. We want to line up with those vertical dots, so that was too far to the left. There's two dots that are vertically up and down. So we're gonna try again. So we're gonna zigzag up and bonk just over those two vertical dots up there. There we go. That should be good. There we go. That looks good. This one's pretty straightforward. You're just going to go around to the back. And you're going to aim between where there's that little dip there. And you'll bonk just on the blue light. We'll check it. Looks great. Nice little swag boost from the laser. This one's kind of hard. It was also raining because this one involves climbing. So we're going to run behind the shrine. And there's a little divot up here. I'll explain it while I fail these few tries. But basically we want to climb up. And then after we do about one jump of the climb, we're going to press B. And then you're going to quickly shield jump up against this little divot. There's a little arrow up here coming up. But here's the right one. Right there. You want to bonk right about there. And you'll slide down the wall. Man, that looks good. This is kind of a fun one. You're actually just going to face the door. It's not totally north, but that's okay. You're going to face the door and just line up on the edge of the shrine here. Backflip. And then just shield jump from there forward. So it looks like I mess up here. I'm gonna assume, I think I just jumped a little too early there. Sometimes if you do that thing where it shoots you forward, but then you don't clip through the wall and you kind of bounce back. Sometimes that means you just jumped a little too soon. So this one we're gonna face true north and line up against this tree. And we want Link's head to split the tree, the left edge of the tree. And then you're gonna do two side hops to the right and then one shield jump. That looks good. Let's see what I did wrong on this one. So this one, I believe I jumped too late. And I gave it a few tries. Couldn't really get the height on these first few tries. You really want to try and get fairly close to the sconce on the wall up there. But it's also just a matter of kind of it being finicky. So for this one, we're going to face north, obviously. Target the little lip here, and then move a little bit to the left. So I got hit with a laser there. Unfortunately, it did not do anything, but you can, if the timing is weird, that laser can ruin your skew and you get stuck in there. So just keep that in mind. So this one we're gonna jump on top of here with the shield jump. And this is similar. We're gonna actually just run up. So those two vertical dots are what we're going for. I didn't get skew on this one. So I tested it here, and there's nothing, you know, it's not really strong enough. It probably would have been fine, but I think I just wanted to play it safe. And I reset the skew here, not because you have to, but because it just makes it easier to get up on this lip. It's not necessary to do that, though. So yeah, so we're aiming for that dot there. That's where you want to go. There we go, that's much better. It probably would have been fine before, but let's see what I did here. Yeah, just a little too low. I basically just, I shield surfed just a little bit too soon after the jump. You kind of want to jump and give it like a half a beat before doing the show, so just so you get some extra height. Here, we're going to just target that dot, that circle. And it doesn't matter that I didn't slide down or anything. That's got it's really more about where the shield bonks. This one's kind of similar in that we need to jump up the side. We don't need to shield jump though, we can make it otherwise. And we're gonna go for that little dot there. So this is another zigzagger. We're gonna have to run up the back and then try to line up with the vertical dots. So we're gonna come up here again. There's the little line for you. Turn it and then bonk over those two vertical dots. That's looking good. I'm not totally sure what I did wrong there. That might have just been something with the timing, obviously. And I think, yeah, now that I look at it, I think I jumped too low in that first try. Or maybe I unequipped shield too late. Yep, just gonna go with that little crack, that blue crack, right where that T is. So this one, we actually don't use the shrine. There's a slope up here that when you face it, it faces the right way. It's facing north, the upwards part of it. And you're just gonna bonk right into the middle of it. And you can kind of check it on the way down here. So there's an example of not a very strong skew, but still effective. It's really more about the angle than the strength. So this one's similar to Talo Neg. We want to aim for the circle. I was a little bit too far to the left on that one. I tested it anyway, but it was no good. So you want to bonk on that big fat circle up there. Yeah, there we go. It's the same as Talo Neg. Yeah, so I messed this one up. That was, I unequipped a little bit too late. I jumped too late. Everything about it was just late. There we go. That's better. If you get too close to the wall before you unequip it, it doesn't work. Unless, I mean, it's all in relation to the skew you have, but for that particular skew, it didn't work. So this one, I got a little bit too far left in the setup, but you're going to run up the angle here. You see how I kind of floated there? That was too far left. But you're going to run up the angle, kind of like you would for Talo Neg. But you're going to keep going, and you want to bonk on the two vertical dots. aiming just above the blue. Let's see what I did wrong here. Yeah, too late. You could see that I was kind of, the whole shield was in there. That's better. So this one we use a little bit of a climb. You gotta run up to the right of that big fat circle and then bonk on this line. Looks good. See, that one I was fairly late on, but it still worked. And I think it's because the skew just was not the same as the other skew. It's really about the relation. You're just gonna aim to land right where that, right above where the black star, right above the snow, and where the black starts on the shrine. Okay, we just have one. Oh, two more. You're gonna just basically go to the left of the dot there, of the circle. And I think I double checked this because I wasn't sure. I doubted it, but it ended up being good. Alrighty, now Hyrule Castle, the door is facing west, so we come around this way, and we jump on top of this lip, and this one's a little strange. You want to get in between these two dots. It's pretty much a straight shot, though, once you line it up. There we go. Alrighty, that's going to do it. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that this video helps you. And again, I just strongly encourage that you explore on your own and maybe find your own setups for SKU now that you have somewhat of a basic understanding of it. Be sure to check out the links that I mentioned. And if you want to check me out, I'm on Twitch. I'm currently streaming Breath of the Wild All Shrines speedruns that I'm working on. But I definitely will be doing some other categories as well in the future. So I'll include my link to my Twitch below. And yeah, thanks again for watching. And just hope you have a good rest of your day.